Number one, and the name of the unit is Fundamentals of Color Television. To understand color television, we must understand some basics of monochrome television. And I am presenter Suvarna Kadam. So let us start with our first session of this particular audio video engineering with the elements of the television system. Whenever I'm talking about the elements of the television system, every time, like, see, this is nothing but the how we are going to categorize our system. So here, these are nothing but the elements. What we require here in audio and video engineering, the first component is nothing but the, otherwise two things are there. One is audio and other one is nothing but the video. So your normal audio is not going to transmit with any transmission media. So you need to convert your audio into the electrical signal, and which is nothing but the function of the microphone. So the function of the microphone is to convert your audio into the electrical signal or into the electrical quantity, which we refer as a signal. So here we need to amplify that particular audio signal. Okay, whenever you are talking about the generation of audio signal, the signals are not of that strength which may drive your modulating amplifier, which may use for the modulation. So here, if you see here, we are going to use two kind of the things. Two signals are there. The first signal which we are using is nothing but the audio signal, and other one is nothing but the video signal, as we are dealing with the audio video engineering. So whenever you are talking about the audio signal and whenever you are talking about the video signal, the signals are not transmitted as they are generated. AVE, audio video engineering, and I'm dealing with the television now. So as I'm dealing with the television, I need a sound, which is nothing but the audio, and I need a vision or video signal. So here, whenever these signals are transmitted, audio signal will be modulated. You're not going to transmit the signal as it is generated, as they're very of low frequency signal. So if I want to convert it into the high frequency, I need to modulate it. So the frequency modulation is used for audio signal, and the amplitude modulation is used for the video signal. Now I am discussing only about the basic monochrome television, which does not contain any color information. Okay, basically this television is referred as a black and white television. ठीक है, मोनोक्रोम टेलीविजन जो सिर्फ इंटेंसिटी वेरिएशंस देता है आपको. सो इसमें आपके दो सिग्नल्स है, एक है ऑडियो और दूसरा है वीडियो. ऑडियो इज फ्रीक्वेंसी मॉड्यूलेटेड एंड वीडियो इज एम्पलीट्यूड मॉड्यूलेटेड. तो टू हैव अ फ्रीक्वेंसी मॉड्यूलेशन, आई नीड अ मॉड्यूलेटर. सो हियर यू आर हैविंग अ एफएम मॉड्यूलेटिंग एम्पलीफायर, देन हियर यू आर हैविंग अ एफएम साउंड ट्रांसमीटर. सो ऑडियो प्रोसेसिंग इज डन विद दिस पर्टिकुलर थ्री ब्लॉक्स एंड इट इज गिवन टू द कंबाइनिंग नेटवर्क. आई एम नॉट एट ऑल इंटरेस्टेड ओनली इन द ऑडियो सिग्नल, बट आई नीड वीडियो सिग्नल. ठीक है, सो आपका वीडियो सिग्नल कहां से होता है? दिस इज द टेलीविजन कैमरा. इफ आई सी कैमरा, देन इन द टेलीविजन सिस्टम कैमरा इज द हार्ट ऑफ माय टेलीविजन सिस्टम, बिकॉज व्हाट एवर लाइट फॉल्स ऑन दिस कैमरा विल बी कन्वर्टेड इनटू द इलेक्ट्रिकल सिग्नल और इलेक्ट्रिकल क्वांटिटी, एंड देन इट विल बी गिवन टू द वीडियो एम्पलीफायर. यहां पे सिर्फ वीडियो बूस्टिंग हो जाता है. हियर यू आर यूजिंग अ मॉड्यूलेशन. ठीक है, सो दिस विल बी द एएम मॉड्यूलेटिंग एम्पलीफायर. सो एम्पलीट्यूड मॉड्यूलेशन का जो भी आपका मॉड्यूलेटिंग एम्पलीफायर वो बूस्ट करेगा, हियर इट विल बी द पावर एम्पलीफायर. व्हाट आई नीड फॉर एम्पलीट्यूड मॉड्यूलेशन, आई नीड सम कैरियर सिग्नल. ठीक है, सो क्रिस्टल ऑसिलेटर इज द ब्लॉक विच जनरेट्स द कैरियर सिग्नल. इट इज एम्पलीफाइड एंड गिवन इनटू टू द पावर एम्पलीफायर. सो मॉड्यूलेटिंग एम्पलीफायर विल एम्पलीफायर सिग्नल. द मॉड्यूलेशन प्रोसेस टेक्स इन दिस टू पर्टिकुलर ब्लॉक्स. ठीक है, एंड दैट एम्पलीट्यूड मॉड्यूलेटेड सिग्नल विल बी गिवन टू द कंबाइनिंग नेटवर्क. Now here one thing I require to have a synchronization between my transmitter and a receiver. This is my transmitting antenna. If you'll see here, this is the transmitting antenna. This antenna will be the transmitting antenna. Here my amplitude modulated video signal will be there, and here my frequency modulated audio signal will be there. ठीक है, यहाँ से तो आपका signal जा रहा है, लेकिन whenever it goes to the receiver, how my receiver will understand, how my receiver will get synchronized? To have a synchronization, I have a different circuit which is called as a scanning and synchronizing circuit. This is a bit tricky, or this is a bit complex, I can say, block which we need to understand in a very, or you वेरी इन डिटेल, ठीक है, एंड दैट वी आर गोइंग टू कवर लेटर. राइट नाउ यू अंडरस्टैंड दिस स्कैनिंग एंड सिंक्रोनाइजिंग सर्किट्स प्रोवाइड्स द पल्सेस विच आर यूज्ड फॉर सिंक्रोनाइजेशन बिटवीन ट्रांसमीटर एंड रिसीवर. देयर मस्ट बी अ सिंक्रोनाइजेशन वेन एवर यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द कम्युनिकेशन सिस्टम. सो दिस इज नथिंग बट द एलिमेंट्स ऑफ टेलीविजन सिस्टम एंड दिस इज द टेलीविजन ट्रांसमीटर, ठीक है. नाउ टू हैव दिस काइंड ऑफ अ रिसीवर वॉट काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स आई नीड टू डू हियर. आपका जो भी एलिमेंट्स ऑफ टेलीविजन सिस्टम है ये आपका रिसीवर है, ये जो भी आपका ट्रांसमिट हुआ है यहाँ पे रिसीव हो गया, ठीक है. सो फर्स्ट इज नथिंग बट द ट्यूनर. नाउ ट्यूनर इज ट्यून टू सिलेक्ट ओनली दैट पर्टिकुलर फ्रीक्वेंसी. इफ आई एम सेइंग माय टेलीविजन बैंडविड्थ इज 7 MHz, दिस ट्यूनर इज ट्यून टू दैट 7 MHz ओनली. सो वॉट इट विल डू, इट विल सिलेक्ट दैट फ्रीक्वेंसीज इन द रेंज ऑफ सपोज 41 to 48 MHz. तो ये वाला, this is tuned to this frequency, select only these frequencies, ठीक है. Now it is given to the common IF amplifier. Now this will amplify that particular signal. ये IF होता है intermediate frequency which you might have studied in your analog communication. Let any frequency come to this particular signal. Now suppose I'm talking about the range of frequencies, my television starts at 41 to say 300 megahertz or something like that, if I consider the two bands only. So ye jo range hai uske liye tune karna mushkil ho jata hai aapka RF tuner. So what generally you do, you convert, or for this variable range it's very difficult to design a detector also. So you're converting that frequency into a fixed frequency, and that frequency, suppose your incoming frequency is fs, yahan pe aap dusra ek local oscillator frequency generate karte ho, and you generate the if frequency. FIF is equal to fs minus f0. So this is what we called as the intermediate frequency, and that will be given to the video detector. Actually this is a demodulation, क्योंकि आपका एम्पलीट्यूड सिग्नल जो है, आपका जो भी वीडियो सिग्नल है, दैट इज एम्पलीट्यूड मॉड्यूलेटेड. सो दिस इज डीमॉड्यूलेशन टेक्स प्लेस हियर एंड इट्स गिवन टू द वीडियो एम्पलीफायर. द सेम स्कैनिंग एंड सिंक्रोनाइजिंग सर्किट विल बी हियर टू हैव अ सिंक्रोनाइजेशन बिटवीन योर ट्रांसमीटर एंड रिसीवर. सो फ्रॉम वेयर यू आर गोइंग टू गेट दैट स्कैनिंग एंड सिंक्रोनाइजिंग इनपुट फ्रॉम द सेम वीडियो सिग्नल, एंड हाउ वी आर गोइंग टू गेट इट, दैट वी विल discuss separately. And it is given to the picture tube. यहाँ पे आपका deflection circuit होता है, ठीक है, and to this deflection circuit you are giving this scanning and synchronizing pulses, and this is the picture tube where actually you are going to see the video. ये हो गया आपके video का. What about audio? Whenever you are separating out video, at that point you are separating out audio also. The first stage which you are doing here is nothing but the amplification of that particular. This is also IF, ठीक है, intermediate frequency you are going to get it. Then you are going to demodulate that signal. As it is frequency modulated, you need to use here frequency demodulator. Then audio amplifier, and the final output goes to the loudspeaker. So if you see, आपने वहां पे जहाँ पे माइक्रोफोन का इनपुट है वो डीमॉड्यूलेट होकर लाउड स्पीकर को जा रहा है. आपका यहाँ पे जो भी कैमरा इनपुट है वो आपका यहाँ पे पिक्चर ट्यूब को जा रहा है. सो वॉट एवर प्रोसेसेस आर डन बाय माइक्रोफोन, एग्जैक्टली अपोजिट प्रोसेसेस विल बी डन बाय लाउड स्पीकर. वॉट एवर इज डन बाय योर कैमरा ट्यूब, एग्जैक्टली अपोजिट प्रोसेस विल हैपन हियर इन योर पिक्चर ट्यूब. सो दीज आर नथिंग बट द बेसिक मोनोक्रोम टेलीविजन ट्रांसमीटर्स एंड रिसीवर्स. Once you understand what is transmitter, it is very easy for you to understand the receiver, because exactly opposite processes. You're doing modulation, here demodulation. The amplifiers are just to boost your signal. So some additional amplifiers you might see here. The next one is nothing but the Vidicon camera tube. As I told you that to understand that camera tube, you must understand, to understand the picture tube, you must understand the Vidicon camera. So this is a very basic camera, whereas you can see this here, there will be the object which you are going to televise. Suppose you are having this kind of a picture here. So jo bhi light is object se fall hota hai, theek hai, that light will be focused with this focusing lens on one conducting or one surface. This is a glass plate which is coated with a conductive coating, and this conductive coating, now whenever light, photoconductive material, it is made up of a photoconductive surface. So whenever light falls on this particular surface, its conductivity changes. What do you mean by this particular phenomena? When you are saying conductivity changes, means the resistance of that particular material changes. So this particular resistance changes. When this resistor changes, when the photons or the light falls on that particular object. So here, when this particular light will be fall on this particular surface, the conductivity changes, and that change in the conductivity, suppose I have this kind of the face plate, they have given you the cross sectional or simplified cross sectional area. Agar aapka ye pura surface hai aur yahan pe ye jo image ka object, जो भी आपका इमेज है वो यहाँ पे ऐसे फॉल हुआ है, ठीक है, हर एक जगह पे जैसे जैसे उसका आपका कंडक्टिविटी चेंज होगा. नाउ व्हाट यू नीड टू डू हियर, यू नीड टू कलेक्ट दैट इंफॉर्मेशन. हाउ यू आर गोइंग टू कलेक्ट दैट इंफॉर्मेशन, यूजिंग दिस पर्टिकुलर इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम. नाउ दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम मूव्स फ्रॉम दिस पॉइंट, पूरा सरफेस पे वो मूव हो जाता है, एंड इट मूव्स विद अ वेरी फास्ट रेट, पूरा ये वाला, ठीक है. सो who is responsible of for this particular electron beam movement? This is the cathode. When you hit cathode, the electrons will be emitted. That electron, whenever electrons will be emitted, this forms a electron beam. Now you are moving this electron beam with so fast rate. Now how, what will be the rate here? Aap jo bhi yahan se leke, now ye beam yahan se leke yahan jayega, fir wapas aayega, fir yahan jayega, fir yahan aayega, fir ye, aur ye rate itna zyada hota hai, in 1 second the movement will be 50 times, theek hai, from up to down. And how many such lines are scanned in 1 second? 1, 5, 6, 5. ठीक है, सो 1, 5, 6, 5. हाउ मेनी सच लाइन्स विल बी देयर? 1, 5, 6, 5. सो यहां से लेके, सो दैट मूवमेंट इज सो फास्ट एंड दैट यूर आईज आर नॉट एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड. सो दिस पर्टिकुलर मेथड विल बी कॉल्ड एज द स्कैनिंग मेथड. सो यहाँ पे आपका पूरा जो भी स्कैनिंग हो जाएगा, दैट विल बी कलेक्टेड, एंड दैट सिग्नल इज नथिंग बट द यूर वीडियो सिग्नल, एंड विल बी कलेक्टेड अक्रॉस दिस लोड रजिस्टर. क्योंकि आप यहाँ पे कलेक्ट कर रहे हो, दिस इज ग्राउंड, सो दिस इज कनेक्टेड, सो योर वीडियो signal will be collected across, and this output will be given to the transmission, and this video output signal will be given for amplitude modulation modulator for modulation. I hope the things are clear. So this is the very basic video con camera tube which is used to capture your video signal, only video. I'm not talking right now about the audio signal. ठीक है? Now scanning, जैसे मैंने आपको बोला था, what happens actually, your electron beam, as you are reading the book, what happens, your electron beam starts scanning from here to here, ठीक है? Then it goes back, ठीक है? Then again like that, ठीक है? जैसे आप एक line read करते हो, वापस आ जाते हो, फिर रीड करते हो. फ्रॉम वेयर यू आर गेटिंग द इंफॉर्मेशन व्हेन यू आर रीडिंग योर लाइन फ्रॉम हियर टू हियर, सो दिस पर्टिकुलर विल बी कॉल्ड एज द ट्रेस. ठीक है, जहां पे एक्चुअली यू आर गेटिंग द इंफॉर्मेशन, दिस पीरियड विल बी कॉल्ड एज अ ट्रेस. फ्रॉम आई कैन से लेफ्ट टू राइट विल बी कॉल्ड एज अ ट्रेस, एंड राइट टू लेफ्ट, दिस इज नथिंग बट यू आर नॉट गेटिंग एनीथिंग, जस्ट मूविंग बैक यूर इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम टू द पोजिशन वेर यू आर गोइंग टू ट्रेस अगेन. सो दिस विल बी कॉल्ड एज अ रीट्रेस. सो रीट्रेस इज हैविंग अ वेरी मिनिमम इन्फॉर्मेशन, और इट इज नॉट हैविंग एनी इन्फॉर्मेशन, एंड ट्रेस इज हैविंग द मैक्सिमम इन्फॉर्मेशन. सो दिस इज नथिंग बट ये जो भी आपका ग्लास का फेस प्लेट है, ये आपकी विड्थ है और ये आपका height hai. So this is the path of the scanning in covering the picture area. So if this is the picture area, your picture area will be covered from left to right, then right to left, left to right, like that. Theek hai? So the next is nothing but the पिक्चर रिसेप्शन. हाउ यू गोइंग टू रिसीव दिस पर्टिकुलर पिक्चर? आपने पिक्चर कैप्चर कर दिया, ठीक है, जिस रेट के साथ आपका वहां पे इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम मूव हो रहा है उसी रेट के साथ, सो यू विल हैव अ डिफ्लेक्शन कॉइल्स विच विल अलाउ दिस इलेक्ट्रॉन बीम टू मूव विद द सेम रेट, एंड फॉर दैट पर्पज वी नीड अ स्कैनिंग एंड अ सिंक्रोनाइजिंग सर्किट. सो हियर यू आर गोइंग टू दिस कैथोड, टू दिस पर्टिकुलर कैथोड यू आर गोइंग टू गिव योर वीडियो सिग्नल. आप यहाँ पे आपका वीडियो सिग्नल देंगे, ठीक है, और आपका जो बीम मूवमेंट होगा विद सेम, सो इंटेंसिटी ऑफ दिस बीम विल बी सेम एज यू आर प्रोवाइडिंग द वीडियो सिग्नल. सो when intensity, and here this particular screen will be coated with the phosphor coating. Jaise bhi aapka conduction hai yahan pe, whenever you are giving video signal to the cathode, that particular intensity will be controlled by your video signal, and the movement of this beam will be same as the movement of your Videocon camera scanning and synchronizing circuit or scanning circuit. So this deflection coil will have a same kind of the deflection, and it produces, and whenever this electron beam strikes on this phosphor coating, it illuminates the light, and that light will be of the same intensity of that object which you have scanned over there. So whatever you have done there, exactly opposite process you're doing at the picture tube. Okay, so elements of the picture tube will be, first is the base, second is the heater to heat the cathode, then this is the cathode to generate the electron beam, and this will be the control grid to whom which we are giving the video signal to control the intensity according to our object. Then these are the accelerating anodes, these are the focusing anode to just have alignment or proper alignment of that electron beam. Deflection coils, there will be the two types of the deflection coils, because what there will be the horizontal deflections and there will be the vertical deflection. What we want, if this is your glass face plate or if this is your picture tube, aapko yahan se leke yahan tak bhi aana hai, wapas yahan pe aana hai. So you need a horizontal movement plus you need a vertical movement also. Beam ko upar se leke niche lana hai, niche se leke upar leke jana hai. So this will be called as the vertical movements. Theek hai? So you need a two deflection circuits here, horizontal deflection circuit, and other one is nothing but the vertical deflection circuit. So this is all about the picture reception. Now we'll discuss about the receiver controls. How many receiver controls? This is a very basic television. We are not using this television nowadays, but these are very, very basic monochrome television which we were using when we were small. Okay, so at that time we were having Onida, BPL, such kind of the televisions where we are having this kind of the control, vertical hold, whereas if this picture starts rolling, we use to this vertical hold. Channel selector, this is nothing but the channel selector knob. To select any channel we need to move this particular knob. Fine tuning, iske ऊपर एक और मूवेबल कंट्रोल हुआ करता था जिसे हम चेंज करके वे यूज टू ट्यून इट फाइनली. कॉन्ट्रास्ट, कॉन्ट्रास्ट एंड ब्राइटनेस, दीज आर द टू डिफरेंट थिंग्स. ठीक है, कॉन्ट्रास्ट इज नॉट सेम एज द ब्राइटनेस. सो कॉन्ट्रास्ट कंट्रोल इज अ डिफरेंट थिंग एंड ब्राइटनेस इज जस्ट द इंटेंसिटी लेवल का आप जो चेंज कर रहे हो, ब्राइटर डार्कर, दैट इज नथिंग बट द ब्राइटनेस कंट्रोल. नेक्स्ट वन इज नथिंग बट द वॉल्यूम कंट्रोल. सो वी आर हैविंग वन नॉब विच इज कॉल्ड एज वॉल्यूम कंट्रोल. दूसरा होता है ऑन ऑफ, आपको टेलीविजन ऑन करना है ऑफ करना है. टोन, टू सिलेक्ट अ पर्टिकुलर फ्रिक्वेंसी. ठीक है, तो ये टोन कंट्रोल हुआ. सॉरी, दिस इज फॉर ऑडियो. आई एम सो सॉरी, दिस इज फॉर ऑडियो टोन कंट्रोल. ठीक है, सो दीज नॉब्स वेर देयर फॉर दैट पर्टिकुलर रिसीवर कंट्रोल. ठीक है, कंपैटिबिलिटी. नाउ व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय कंपैटिबिलिटी? आई हैव अ मोनोक्रोम टेलीविजन. ठीक है, एंड दिस इज द मोनोक्रोम टेलीविजन कैमरा विच फोकसेस दैट पर्टिकुलर picture and that will be converted into the amplitude modulated signal and which will be transmitted, and it will be received through monochrome receiver, because my monochrome receiver will have only one electron gun, because you're going to produce black and white pictures on the black and white picture tube, kyunki wo aapne coat kiya hai phosphor screens ke sath. You need only intensity variation. When I talk about the monochrome television, I am just dealing with the intensities, not with the colors. But after that, in 1954, I guess the first color television comes into the picture, whereas your picture was colorful and it was giving you more details, more clear picture, more colorful picture. So whereas here, how that particular processing, previously you were just collecting the intensity variations, now you are collecting the colors. So are you going to color? There are n number of colors in this particular nature. So are we going to process each and every color? No, we are using three basic colors, red, green and blue. Okay, these are the colors which can generate any color in the world if you use it in a proper proportion. So you are using the optical filters, that is red filter, green filter, blue filter. Then that filter signal will be combined appropriately, or as this particular object is, output of this particular object falls on the red, green and blue cameras. These are the cameras. This is only a single camera, which is monochrome camera, but you are having a red camera, green camera, blue camera, which collects only red information, green information and blue information. So proper combination of these three colors will give you the object color, and that will be given to the color receiver. This will be the transmission path. But color receiver will have three kinds of the electron guns. You are having only one electron gun here. Here you're having a red gun, green gun, and a blue gun. So रेड आउटपुट और द रेड कैमरा का जो भी इनपुट है सिर्फ रेड गन को जाएगा, ब्लू का जो है वो ब्लू को जाएगा, ग्रीन का जो है ग्रीन को जाएगा. एंड हियर यू आर हैविंग अ रेड ग्रीन ब्लू फॉस्फर्स. सो रेड आउटपुट विल इग्नाइट ओनली अ रेड फॉस्फर, ग्रीन आउटपुट विल इग्नाइट ओनली ग्रीन, एंड कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ दिस कलर विल गिव यू द अप्रोप्रिएट कलर विच यू हैव टेलीवाइज्ड ओवर देयर. सो दिस इज द प्रोसेस. नाउ the compatibility is the major issue. What do you mean by compatibility? You are transmitting a color signal which will appear color on your color screen, but that color signal should not give any random information on the monochrome television. It should give a proper intensity change or intensity variations on the monochrome television. Though you are televising a monochrome signal, it will appear monochrome on monochrome receiver, but it should not generate any random colors on the color receiver. So this particular thing is called as the compatibility. So signal transmission path illustrating compatibility between color and monochrome television. So here it shows the compatibility. RGB represents the three camera tubes which develops video signal corresponding to the red, green, and blue contents of the scene being televised. So compatibility is nothing but the your color picture must be produced on monochrome television with a proper intensity variations, and your monochrome picture should give a proper the monochrome picture must be very, it should not give any random color though your receiver is color receiver. So it should be produced properly. So this is what we called as the compatibility. Next one is nothing but the analysis and synthesis of television system. So what we mean by analysis and synthesis? In this analysis and synthesis, the basic factor with which the television system must deal for successful transmission and reception of the picture. So first here is nothing but the first is the gross structure. Gauss structure is nothing but the geometric form and aspect ratio of the picture. Now we'll discuss each and every term separately. Next is the image continuity, scanning and its sequence. The third is the number of scanning lines. How many scanning lines we should choose for the proper detailing of the picture. Then next one is nothing but the flicker. Flicker kya hota hai aur how we can reduce that flicker. So here we'll discuss the different type of scanning, that is interlaced scanning. Then fine structure. So in the fine structure, we'll talk about vertical and horizontal resolution. Then we'll talk about the tonal gradation. Tonal gradation, this is a picture brightness transfer characteristics of the system. So let us discuss one by one each and every term. Now when I say gross structure is nothing but the width to height ratio. Suppose I have a television like this. So agar aapke paas aapka television hai, so here height to width ratio, this will be the height and this will be the width. So ye jo ratio hai ise hum bolenge aspect ratio. So height to width ratio. Here if I talk about the standard definition television, yahan pe hum analog ki baat kar rahe hain ya fir standard television ki baat kar rahe, will not use a term definition, because when we use this term definition, it comes under a digital television. So when I talk about the standard television, the width to height ratio is 4:3. Means here if your width is 4, your height will be 3. Theek hai? Now you can understand your television is bit wider here. Theek hai? Now what is the reason behind this? This is the question which is always asked in your oral examination. Why your height width to height ratio is 4:3? Why your televisions are more wider? So the first reason here is nothing but the, if I talk about the first reason is nothing but the, in human affairs, see, your motions generally occurs in the horizontal plane. ठीक है, so here you need a larger width. If you see your eyes can view more ease and comfort when the width of the picture is more than height. Have you tried watching a vertical television? It will not be comfortable for you. Your eyes are horizontal in nature, so your eyes will be more comfortable viewing horizontal things. Okay? The second reason is the usage of rectangular frame in the motion picture with the width-height ratio 4:3 is another important reason for adopting the shape and aspect ratio. This enables direct television transmission of film programs without wastage of the film area. If you see your films, film area, they're having rectangular frames, and that's why without wasting that area, your picture can be stored on that particular film. The next one is nothing but the image continuity. Now, the sensation produced when the nerves of our eyes, retina, are stimulated by incident light does not cease immediately after the light is removed, but persists for about 1/16 of the second. कोई भी चीज आपकी आंखों के सामने से अगर हटा भी दी जाए तो भी उसका जो इमेज है वो आपके ब्रेन में 1/16 of second remains as it is, and it is called as a persistence of vision. So thus, if the scanning rate per second is made greater than 16, or the number of pictures shown per second is more than 16, the eye is able to integrate the changing levels of brightness in the scenes. Now here I need to write, your eyes will not be able to integrate between the changing levels. ठीक है, अगर आपने दो pictures, if you move your two pictures with very fast rate by 1/16 of second, your brain and your eyes, they will not have that particular sense that there will be the change in that particular frame. So it will create a continuity between that two images. Okay? So when the picture elements are scanned rapidly enough, they appears to the eyes as a complete picture unit with none of the individual elements visible separately. Means continuity will be there. So in present day motion pictures, 24 still pictures of the scene are taken per second and later projected on the screen at the same rate. You are scanning 24 still pictures per second in the motion picture, and in the television you are doing it 25 frames. Number of complete picture or frames per second, ठीक है, to give the illusion of continuous motion. So this is called as the scanning. And here, instead of 24 as in the commercial motion picture, in practice we use 25 frames per second in the television system. So we'll see horizontal scanning first. So horizontal scanning, instead of reading this one, I'll just show you the picture. What do you mean by horizontal scanning here? So in the horizontal scanning, the movement of your electronic beam or electron beam is from left to right, and then right to left. Then this will be the start of the next line. Then this will be written. So whenever you are getting some information, this particular line will be called as a trace. Or jo movement aapka from right to left hota hai, usse hum bolenge retrace. So this is nothing but the path of the scanning beam in a covering picture area. And this complete picture area, illuminated screen will be called as the raster. ठीक है? So horizontal scanning mein, who is responsible for this particular horizontal scanning? Your horizontal deflection coils. This horizontal deflection coils produces a sawtooth current waveform. ठीक है? So during the first line, during the trace, it will be have this kind of, see your movement बीम का जो होता है फ्रॉम लेफ्ट टू राइट, सो ये सॉटूथ वेवफॉर्म यहाँ से रिस्पॉन्सिबल है. जैसे आपका करंट इंक्रीज हो जाता है फ्रॉम मिनिमम टू मैक्सिमम, योर बीम मूव्स फ्रॉम लेफ्ट टू राइट, देन रिट्रेस. नाउ यू सी द चेंज विल बी देयर इन द डायरेक्शन ऑफ योर करंट. नाउ इट इज इन द अपोजिट डायरेक्शन, सो एट दैट टाइम रिट्रेस टेक्स प्लेस. सो हॉरिजॉन्टल डिफ्लेक्शन कॉइल्स produces a sawtooth waveform which are responsible for the movement of your electron beam, which moves your electron beam from left to right and right to left. Whenever this current is rising from zero to maximum value, your movement of beam will be from left to right, and whenever it reverses the direction and goes again down, your movement of beam will be from left to right? And this particular process is called as the horizontal scan. Vertical scanning. Vertical scanning, again I'll show you one image, whereas you can see vertical scanning kya hota hai, aapka jo bhi beam hai, it moves from top to bottom and bottom to top again. So how many times this movement will be done? If I told you that in a television system 25 frames are scanned per second, so my movement of this particular electron beam must be 25 times in 1 second. So who is responsible for this movement of this electron beam? That is again is a vertical deflection coils, and this vertical deflection coil or a vertical deflection circuit is responsible to have that top to bottom and bottom to top movement. So jab aapka ye top to bottom, suppose your current, now this vertical deflection coil generate a sawtooth waveform. When this current is rising to the maximum value, your movement will be from top to bottom. Always trace is having a larger duration than retrace, because information is gathered during a trace time. Retrace time or a retrace is just to move back your beam from bottom to top. ये invisible होना चाहिए, क्योंकि यहाँ पे आप कोई information नहीं ले रहे हो. So always if you see your sawtooth current waveform का जो trace time है वो ज्यादा है और retrace time जो है वो कम है. So during the retrace time your beam or electron beam moves from bottom to top. ठीक है. So this will be the vertical retrace and this will be the linear vertical trace. आपका now with your vertical trace your horizontal trace is also going on. ठीक है. So this is something which we need to understand. These are the current waveforms in the vertical deflection coil. The next one is nothing but the number of scanning lines. How we are going to decide how much number of scanning lines we must use? Okay. So here we have taken one example. This is a dark line or dark line. This is a white line. This is dark line. This is white line. So to have this kind of resolution, if my eye, now always it is recommended that if your television is having a height of h, your viewing distance, ideal viewing distance is 4 to 8 times than this height of your television. ठीक है. आपके पास दो adjacent dark और white bands है, या फिर two adjacent black picture elements. So what should be the resolution? ये आपका nth line है और ये आपका n plus 1 line है. So your eyes are more comfortable when you set it to the critical viewing distance. So critical viewing distance is determined by the ability of the eye to resolve two separate picture elements. What I need here to have a clear idea about what I am watching, what I am observing, my eyes must be set, or my eye must be able to distinguish between that two objects, two separate picture elements. So if you are putting one object on nth line, you are putting another object on the n plus line, this will be the angle, this will be sustained at the eye by picture elements at the critical viewing distance. So that will be the alpha. So we need to consider distance, we need to consider this alpha as a viewing angle, whereas this is the angle which allows me to distinguish between two objects. Okay. So this will be called as a critical angle. So next one is nothing but if I'm talking about this, how many vertical line I should have to have that differentiation, or to have the idea of the two objects. So NV is nothing but the 1 upon alpha rho. So the maximum number of alternate light and dark elements which can be resolved by the eyes is nothing but the 1 by alpha rho. So whereas NV is nothing but the total number of lines to be resolved in the vertical direction. ठीक है. ठीक है. सो वर्टिकल डायरेक्शन में, एंड दिस अल्फा इज द मिनिमम रिजॉल्विंग एंगल ऑफ द आई एक्सप्रेस्ड इन रेडियंस. अगर आप 1 मिनट समझ, इफ यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट द एंगल ऑफ 1 मिनट मीन्स 1/60 degree, देन दिस रो विल डिफाइन डी बाई एच, दैट इज विविंग डिस्टेंस बाय पिक्चर हाइट. जनरली वी कीप दिस एज 4 times ऑफ द टेलीविजन हाइट. सो इट हैज बीन डिटरमाइन एक्सपेरिमेंटली दैट if you want to see two picture elements very clearly, your viewing angle, sorry, your viewing angle must be 1 minute, or critical angle we are keeping 1 minute. ठीक है. उसके बाद distance to height ratio we are keeping 4. So your alpha in radians will be pi by 180 into 1 by 60. ठीक है, जो आपका radians में अपने angle का है. और आपका rho जो है वो d by h है. So d by h डी आपने 4H रखा है, HH विल गेट कैंसल्ड, सो यू विल गेट इट 4. सो योर वर्टिकल लाइंस और द लाइंस टू बी रिजॉल्व इन द वर्टिकल डायरेक्शन आर अप्रोक्सीमेटली 860. ठीक है, सो दिस इज वॉट वी कॉल्ड एज अ वर्टिकल रिजोल्यूशन. हाउ मेनी लाइन्स यू नीड टू रिजॉल्व अ वर्टिकल डायरेक्शन कंपोनेंट्स एंड हाउ मेनी लाइन्स यू विल नीड टू डू दैट इज 860 लाइन्स. So this is the vertical resolution. So statistical analysis and a subjective test carried out to determine the average number of effective lines suggests that about 70% of the total lines or segments get separately scanned in the vertical scanning and the remaining 30% get merged with other elements due to the beam spot falling equally on the consecutive lines. यहाँ जब भी आप horizontal vertical scanning करते हो उसके साथ आपका horizontal scanning भी होता है. So 70% lines here 70% of the total lines or segments get separately scanned in the vertical direction and remaining 30% gets merged. So here your another very important factors come into the picture and that is nothing but the Kale factor. So thus effective number of lines distinctly result are NV into K. So agar ye aap baat dhyan mein rakho to aapka jo bhi effective number of lines hai NR is nothing but the NV into K where K is the resolution factor. Now it lies between 0.65 to 0.75 because 70% of the lines get separately scanned during the vertical direction. ठीक है, so यहाँ पे assuming your Kale factor is 0.7, we get NV into K. So NV we have already calculated, that is 860 into 0.7. So finally it comes as a 602 line. So to have a proper vertical resolution, I need 602 line. So thus as a compromise between quality and cost, the total number of lines inclusive of those lost during vertical retrace has been chosen to be 625 in 625B monochrome television system. ठीक है, so whatever system we are using, that system is a monochrome television system and which uses a 625 lines and that's why it is called as a 625B monochrome system. American system uses 525 lines. ठीक है, so we'll see why, what is the reason behind it. ठीक है, so you can see in the 525 line American system the total number of lines has been fixed 525 because their scanning rate is somewhat higher than us. ठीक है, and that things we are going to cover in the next session. Now what do you mean by flicker? Now what we have already discussed, we have discussed that we are scanning 24 pictures per second in a motion pictures and then for television we are scanning 25 frames per second. Okay, so why it is needed? It is needed to create a illusion of continuity between two images. तो आपको क्या करना है, 16 फ्रेम से ज्यादा रखना है. तो मोशन पिक्चर में आपने 24 रखा है और टेलीविजन में 25 रखा है. ठीक है, दो यू आर कीपिंग योर फ्रेम्स एज अ 25, दे आर नॉट सफिशियंट. नाउ देर मस्ट बी अ स्मूथ ब्लेंडिंग फ्रॉम वन पिक्चर टू द अनदर पिक्चर एंड दिस डजंट हैपन. सो इफ यू आर नॉट एबल, सपोज यू आर हैविंग one very dark picture, one very bright picture, and when you are moving from one image to another image, there is an intermittent blanking, and that is what we called as the flicker. ठीक है, so though you are choosing 25 frames, they are not rapid enough to allow the brightness of one picture or frame to blend smoothly into the next through the time when the screen is blanked between successive frames. ठीक है, now this result is in the flicker of light, that is very annoying, and this is what we called as the flicker effect. ठीक है, so here what we can do to reduce this particular flicker. So this problem यहाँ पे ये जो भी problem है, this problem is solved in the motion picture by showing each picture twice. I have a 24 frames in motion picture, so I'll double it. So 24 का double 48 views of the scene are shown per second, although there are still the same 24 picture frames per second. You have divided the 24 pictures into two fields, एक odd field और एक even field. So as a result of increased blanking rate, flicker is eliminated and that particular scanning is called as the interlaced scanning. Suppose I have this particular complete raster, so I'll just divide all these 625 lines. How many lines we have chosen? 625 lines. So her line ko apne, you just separate out odd lines, 1, 3, 5 and all. Then you separate out the even lines, 2nd, 4th. So they have shown you in between separation, but the separation actually happens that you are separating out the lines like this. So first, third, fifth, seventh, these will be the lines which are there in the odd field up to 625. ठीक है, ये आपका odd field है. 625 lines का half हो जाता है यहाँ पे 312.5. So odd field. Now even field 2, 4, 6 up to 624. So this line will be there in the even field. So what you have done? आपने पूरे picture को दो fields में divide किया. पूरे फ्रेम को दो फील्ड में डिवाइड किया. ऑड लाइंस का ऑड फील्ड बन गया, इवन लाइंस का इवन फील्ड बन गया. एंड देन यू आर स्कैनिंग ईच एंड एवरी फील्ड सेपरेटली. सो नाउ यू आर हैविंग इंस्टेड ऑफ 24 48 फील्ड्स. सो यूर स्कैनिंग रेट गेट्स डबल्ड. ठीक है, इफ यू आर हैविंग 25 फ्रेम्स, नाउ यू आर हैव 50 फील्ड्स एंड यूर स्कैनिंग रेट बिकम्स 50 हर्ट्ज बिकॉज यू आर स्कैनिंग एक्चुअली 50 फील्ड्स पर सेकेंड. So this is what you are doing in the interlace scanning. Okay. So here now we'll see how what will be the horizontal deflection current and what will be the vertical deflection current. So agar aapke kitne lines hai, I'm just trying to give you the calculation. How many lines you are having? You are having a 625 lines. Okay. Aur aapke kitne fields hai? Aapke 25 frames. इसको आपने डबल कर दिया तो ये हो गए 50 फील्ड्स. ठीक है, सो इफ आई वांट टू नो हाउ मेनी लाइंस पर सेकंड आर स्कैन, सो इफ आई वांट टू नो हॉरिजॉन्टल स्कैनिंग फ्रीक्वेंसी, कितने लाइंस आप एक सेकंड में स्कैन कर रहे हो, सो 50 इंटू 625, नाउ इट बिकम्स 15625 hertz. So this frequency is denoted by FH and it is 15625 hertz. अगर मेरे इतने lines एक second में scan हो रहे हैं, तो एक line का duration क्या होना चाहिए? Your one line will have, see, in 1 second you are scanning this much line. So 1 divided by 15625, you do it by yourself. So this comes 64 microsecond. So my one line duration is a 64 microsecond. Abhi mujhe ye 64 microsecond ko kaise divide karna hai? Now if this is my raster, आपका ये लाइन यहाँ से लेके यहाँ तक आता है, वापस ये यहाँ पे यहाँ से जाता है. सो ये पूरा ट्रेस प्लस रिट्रेस इज नथिंग बट द वन लाइन ड्यूरेशन. सो हियर द कैटेगराइजेशन ऑफ दिस 64 माइक्रोसेकंड इज डन लाइक दिस. इन ट्रेस पीरियड इज ऑलवेज मोर. सो 52 माइक्रोसेकंड इज अ ट्रेस पीरियड एंड 12 माइक्रोसेकंड इज द रिट्रेस पीरियड एंड कलेक्टिवली इट विल बी 64 माइक्रोसेकंड. नाउ फर्दर दिस 12 माइक्रोसेकंड इज डिवाइडेड इनटू लाइक सब पार्ट्स दैट विल डिस्कस इन द लेटर सेशंस, बट राइट नाउ यू अंडरस्टैंड दैट 64 माइक्रोसेकंड divides 52 microsecond, this is the trace period, plus 12 microsecond which is the retrace period. Okay, now what about the vertical scanning? Now you are scanning how many frames per second, how many fields per second? 1 second mein aapke 50 fields scan ho rahe hain. Okay, you are scanning 50 fields. So what will be the one field frequency, and this particular will be called as the vertical scanning. So FV. So FV will be 1 by 50. So 1 by 50 is the 20 millisecond. This 20 millisecond is total for ये आपका beam जो है वो ऊपर से लेके नीचे आता है और नीचे से लेके ऊपर जाता है. So this is vertical trace and this will be the vertical retrace. So this 20 millisecond is divided into 18.720 millisecond as a trace period and 1.280 as the retrace period. ठीक है, always your retrace period is smaller than the trace period. These are the sawtooth wave forms generated by vertical deflection circuits, and these are nothing but the sawtooth wave forms generated by horizontal deflection circuit. So this is the complete categorization of how the scanning takes place and how that sawtooth waveforms are responsible for your vertical and horizontal scanning. Next one is nothing but the odd line interlace scanning. यहाँ पे आपने क्या किया है, जैसे मैंने आपको बोला था जब हम interlace scanning करते हैं तो आपके odd line scanning, this is first line, this is third line, this is fifth line up to 625 line, ठीक है, जैसे even second, fourth and so on, ठीक है. So यहाँ पे whenever you are going for the vertical trace, ठीक है, आपका first 292 lines, 1 to 292.5 lines are for trace, then next 20 lines are used for the retrace, ठीक है. So आपका first field बन जाता है 312.5 lines का, ठीक है. The second field, अभी यहाँ जहाँ पे ये खत्म होता है 312.5, वहां से ये स्टार्ट हो जाता है. So 292.5 lines are given for the, now for this I need to give you one calculation. What we have done, we have previously seen here in the previous slide, I think I have shown you, this is your trace time and this is your retrace time. आपका retrace time कितने का है, 1.280 millisecond का है, ठीक है. रिट्रेस टाइम में तो आप कोई इंफॉर्मेशन स्कैन नहीं कर रहे हो, आप सिर्फ उस बीम को वापस ऊपर ला रहे हो, तो ये टाइम आपका जो है वेस्टेज है, दिस इज नॉट यूज्ड इन एक्चुअल स्कैनिंग. सो हाउ मेनी लाइंस गेट वेस्टेड इन दिस वर्टिकल रिट्रेस, सो इफ आई डिवाइड इट विद द वन लाइन पीरियड इट गिव्स मी द 20 लाइंस, ठीक है. सो हर फील्ड के बाद जब आप ट्रेस करते हो पूरा फ्रॉम टॉप टू बॉटम, फ्रॉम बॉटम टू टॉप यू नीड 20 लाइंस. So that are not actually used in what? The scanning, but just put that beam from bottom to top. So यहाँ पे you need to consider that 20 lines here. And that's why you can see here, आपके सिर्फ 1 to 292.5 lines ही यहाँ पे use किए हैं, वापस 20 lines you have used for the retrace. Next में आपने यहाँ पे again 312605 और 20 lines again you have put it for the retrace. So 625 lines का अगर पूरा picture है तो उसको half half divide किया है 312.5 312.5, उसमें से complete 292.5 lines are used for vertical trace and other 20 are for vertical retrace. So this is odd line interlace scanning procedure. ठीक है, अगर आपका इंटर, नाउ यू नीड टू डू वन थिंग, जब भी आपका स्कैनिंग शुरू होता है, जब आपका नॉर्मल स्कैनिंग शुरू होता है तो ये स्टार्ट होता है यहाँ से, ठीक है, और ये यहाँ पे खत्म होता है. नाउ इफ यू सी इट एंड्स 292.5 मीन्स हाफ ऑफ द लाइन गेट स्कैन हियर, ठीक है, और दूसरा जो स्टार्ट होता है आपका फील्ड वो हाफ से शुरू होता है क्योंकि वो 292.5 और बिकॉज यू शुड नॉट मिस एनी डिटेल्स फ्रॉम हियर टू हियर. If you are starting and this is the start of alternate field क्योंकि वो half से start होता है, so this is a perfect interlace क्योंकि वो exactly half पे start हुआ है. अगर आपका next frame 16 microsecond delay हो रहा है, इसका मतलब ये यहाँ से start होना चाहिए, but you are having a 16 microsecond delay. Total 32 है क्योंकि 64 का half करने के बाद ये 32 microsecond है, लेकिन आपने delay करा है या फिर there is a problem in the synchronization and you have started it after 16 microsecond, it means that you are having a 50% interlace error. अगर आपका second field यही से start होता है, ठीक है, मतलब from zero duration, then you can say there is a 100% of a interlace error. Your second field must start at after 32 microsecond of that particular line. Now fine structure, what do you mean by fine structure? यहाँ पे fine structure, if I want to define, this is the ability of image reproducing system to represent the fine structure of an object is known as the resolving power or the रेजोल्यूशन. सो एक होता है वर्टिकल रेजोल्यूशन और दूसरा होता है आपका हॉरिजॉन्टल रेजोल्यूशन. सो द एक्सटेंट टू विच द स्कैनिंग सिस्टम इज कैपेबल ऑफ रिजॉल्विंग पिक्चर डिटेल्स इन द वर्टिकल डायरेक्शन विल बी कॉल्ड एज द वर्टिकल रेजोल्यूशन. सो एज वी नो दैट वर्टिकल रेजोल्यूशन इज नथिंग बट द नंबर ऑफ एक्टिव लाइन्स इन टू द स्केल फैक्टर. सो वेयर वी आर इज द वर्टिकल रेजोल्यूशन एक्सप्रेस्ड इन द नंबर ऑफ लाइन्स, एन ए इज नथिंग बट द एक्टिव नंबर ऑफ लाइन्स, वेयर के इज द रेजोल्यूशन फैक्टर दैट इज स्केल फैक्टर. वी हैव सीन वी आर कंसिडरिंग आइदर इट 0.7, यू कैन कंसिडर एनी वैल्यू, 0.65 to 0.75 इज द अलाउड वैल्यू ऑफ दैट स्केल फैक्टर. सो If you are assuming your KEL factor is 0.69, how many lines are there in the vertical resolution 585? Why the 585 lines are taken? How many lines are there actual? As we have already seen, there are actually 625 lines. ठीक है, आपके 625 lines है, उसमें से आप दोनों फील्ड में डिवाइड कर रहे हो 312.5 एंड 312.5. हर इसमें आपके जो 20 लाइंस है वो रिट्रेस के लिए यूज हो रहे, मतलब योर 40 लाइंस आर नॉट एक्टिव लाइंस. सो इफ आई सब्सट्रैक्ट दिस 625 माइनस 40 लाइन, इट कम्स अ 585 लाइंस, बिकॉज दिस मच आर द लाइंस विच आर एक्टिव लाइंस, दैट 40 लाइंस आर इनएक्टिव लाइंस. दैट्स व्हाई 585 इनटू 0.69 एक्चुअल वर्टिकल रेजोल्यूशन इज 400 लाइंस. तो हॉरिजॉन्टल रेजोल्यूशन द सेम definition will be there. The only thing is, this is the capability of the system to resolve maximum number of picture elements along the scanning lines determines horizontal resolution. So this is nothing but the number of active lines into aspect ratio. We have seen aspect ratio is nothing but the width to a height ratio. So active lines are 585, aspect ratio is 4:3, and hence your vertical horizontal resolution will be 780. So here from this we can calculate that the effective number of alternate black and white segments in one horizontal line for equal vertical and horizontal resolution are your active lines 585, your aspect ratio 4:3, and KEL factor, that is 0.69. And that's why horizontal resolution, this is the number of lines which you require to perfectly resolve horizontal component, that is 533. Okay, so video signal bandwidth, I think I have given you vertical resolution, I have given you horizontal resolution. Now how we can calculate the video signal bandwidth? So here we need to find out how much will be the only video signal bandwidth. Now here you do remember that I'm not at all dealing with the audio signal right now, only video signal. How many lines are there? 625 lines. So for a successful transmission and reception, I need my video bandwidth in such a manner. So FH is nothing but the number of active lines, that is 585, aspect ratio 4:3, KEL factor 0.69, and then 2 into time duration of one active line. So what is the active line duration? 64 microsecond mein aapka 12 microsecond retrace period hai, so only 52 microsecond is the active one line duration. So 2 into 52 into 10^6, so 5 megahertz is nothing but the video bandwidth. So you do remember this particular, because it's a very important thing in your oral. So this is us. The 5 megahertz is nothing but the video bandwidth, only video, it does not include audio signal. So video bandwidth will be 5 megahertz. Next one is nothing but the tonal gradation. Tonal gradation, how it appears. So first is the contrast. So this is the difference in the intensity between black and white parts of the picture over and above the brightness level. This is the difference in intensity. Okay, this is not the brightness. Contrast is something different and brightness is something different. So this will be the difference. So contrast ratio, the ratio of the maximum to minimum brightness relative to the original picture, is called as the contrast ratio. So if I see the natural light is having a huge contrast ratio, your camera is not at all able to handle that particular contrast ratio. I think 1000:1, and your camera maximum contrast ratio capability is 100:1. Okay. Next one is the viewing distance. The viewing distance from the screen of the TV receiver should not be so large that the eyes cannot resolve details of the picture. So ideal distance here is 3 to 8 times of the picture height. So the standard distance is 4 times than the antenna. So most people prefer a distance close to 5 times the picture height. While viewing TV, a small light should be kept on in the room to reduce the contrast. Okay, so this does not strain the eyes and there is a less fatigue. So if you are watching the television, you should keep your room or you should turn on your lights, so it will not strain, because at that time that contrast ratio will not be large, contrast ratio will not be there. So this is all about the basics of your television. So thank you, here we'll stop.